And welcome everyone to our next Real Deal on the Skilled Trades discussion with another group of young trailblazing skilled trades women. Joining me is Victoria Reranga, 18, level one plumber apprentice, and Brandy Buncho, 19 years old, level three welding apprentice, and Amanda Lawson, 24 years old, no longer an apprentice or a journey person candidate, but a full-on certified electrician. Thank you all for being here. Amanda, your journey's been the longest, so let me start with you. How did you get interested in becoming an electrician?
So when I was a kid, we used to live out on a farm, and I loved helping my dad out in the shop, and that's where I learned I had a passion for hands-on work. In high school, I was introduced into the construction class, and there from there, I excelled with carpentry and electrical, and I decided to take a co-op, and from there, I've stuck with electrical, and that's how I've started.
Terrific. And how about you, Brandy? How did you get interested in welding?
I got interested in welding. I lived on a dairy farm my whole life. So again, same with Amanda, I like the hands-on learning. And going into grade 9, I actually thought I wanted to be a tractor mechanic. I don't know why, but I had that, I was going to be a tractor mechanic. And I did mechanics, and I hated it. I couldn't figure it out. And then I got introduced to welding in shop class, and I loved it. I fell in love. I did a job shadow in grade 10 with the Venice Custom Welding. Grade 11, I got a summer job. Grade 12, I actually asked if I could do co-op with the same company. Took me in as co-op, and from co-op, I got signed as an OEP, and my apprenticeship started in grade 12.
Right on. What a great path. And I love how it started out with trying something else, realizing it wasn't for you, and then pursuing something else full on right through high school and after. Victoria, 18 years old, you're the youngest here, level one plumber apprentice. How did you get interested in plumbing?
I couldn't imagine working a 9-to-5 office job. So I wanted to explore the different options. Growing up, everybody was pushing me to go into college or university, and I didn't see myself doing that. So throughout high school, I took the woodwork shop class and just tried to embrace the hands-on working. As Brandy and Amanda said, I just love working hands-on. So in grade 12, I got an apprenticeship with a local plumbing company. And from there, with the OEAP program, I was able to enroll in a first term college program for plumbing. And then from there, I was hired full time on with that plumbing company I did my apprenticeship or my co-op with.
Incredible. Full time right out of that apprenticeship. Terrific. How has Victoria being a tradeswoman, you know, changed your life, impacted your life?
It's really forced me to build my character. You come across some challenging situations where you don't always know how to react or handle them. But that being said, it builds your confidence, and over time you understand how to react to a situation and handle it.
That's great. And Brandy, how about yourself, being a woman in the trades? How has your life been changed?
Well, I know in high school, especially, all the guys in shop classes would look at me like, you don't know how to weld that. You don't know how to do that. Well, I'll tell you, I can. And I surprised every single one of them. And I carried that through into the workplace. There'll be a lot of times you go to a job site and they'll be like, oh, I don't usually see a girl in this type of trade. I get that comment all the time. And then you just surprise them. And they're like, wow. Or you show up to a job site by yourself and they're like, are you here to do the welding? Yes, I am. And yeah.
Excellent.
To surprise them.
Excellent. I like that. I like that positive spin. It's fun to surprise people when they have those assumptions. Amanda, I got a feeling you have some sealer stories in your journey, right? Being a woman in the electrician field. What's that been like?
Yeah, so to sum it up, it's how it's changed my life is it has made me a lot more confident. It's helped me better stand up for myself with certain customers or challenges. And I've learned not to take what others say or do so seriously.
Good. How about you, Victoria, being in a male-dominated, you know, not too many quote-unquote female plumbers, as they say. What's that been like?
That's definitely for sure. I haven't found too many challenges. As Brandy said, the male jokes is very prominent in my field. But aside from that, it's more of, oh, do you need help lifting that? Or, hey, you can't carry that. Like, it's too heavy for you. And I go, no, I actually can carry this. Another one is washrooms. It's a taboo subject for some, but this finding a clean spot to go is sometimes quite the issue.
I'm so glad you brought that up. I've researched this. I've talked to different groups. This is something that should be addressed, to be taken really seriously, right? And actually, I think there are guys too who would like to have better spaces for restroom facilities, depending on where they are. It's not just for women that want something more comfortable. How about you, Amanda, being in a, you know, male dominated environment? I think there are, you know, more electricians that are women you're seeing now, but you're still a pioneer.
Yeah. So I've seen very few female electricians, but me, I have been very fortunate along my journey that where I have worked, all of the men see me as an equal. And like I said, I've been very fortunate for that. To touch on what the other girls said, yes, the jokes and just sometimes the guys don't know how to approach you sometimes, or if they're allowed to say certain things. And I think that bothers me more. But other than that, if there's someone, some of the men look at me differently, we realize that we're there for the same reason at the end of the day, is to get the job done.
That's great. And attitude seems to be a real part of it, having that the right attitude when these challenges arise. In addition to everyone having this challenge of being, the minority in terms of gender in an industry, are there any other challenges that you've had to face? I'll stay with you, Amanda. You know, in the journey towards becoming a certified electrician, what other challenges have you had to encounter, and how did you overcome them?
So there's been many challenges. One of the more common challenges, believe it or not, it's not people I work with, it's the people I work for. Customers, the older generations, they're in that mindset. Obviously, it's the male apprentice who's running the show, not the female. I get those looks a lot. I've had customers not trust me because I'm female, so they'll relay something to me and call my boss right away. Is she gonna understand this? Does she know what she's doing? And how I resolve this is I'm not gonna confront the customer. I'm gonna get my job done properly, go back to my shop, and my boss, I tell him my issues, and he is really great at being able to resolve those and deal with the customer and go from there.
That's great. And Victoria, I see you nodding along. Can you relate to what Amanda's saying? What other challenges have you faced?
For sure. I've definitely been in the same situations as Amanda. I know I'm just a first year apprentice, but I have been put on jobs where I'm running the site, and information needs to be relayed to my boss, or certain things need to be changed that day. And they go, can you handle this? Like, I know it might be a little above your knowledge, but kind of thing. But I mean, you don't obviously confront the site super or anything like that. But as Amanda said, you talk to your boss and the boss resolves it.
That's great. So a common theme there, wrong assumptions from the general public and sometimes coworkers, but also being able to rely on a superior, a mentor to help set the record straight. How about you, Brandy? Any challenges that you've addressed?
Well, I can definitely relate to Victoria and Amanda 100%. But my struggle is opposite. When I started, for the life of me, I could not read a tape measure. I can't do fractions. I can't read a tape measure. And I still, well, I'm getting a lot better because I've had like 3 years of practice, but I have to look at my tape measure, and I, for the longest time, I would count the number of ticks on the tape measure, and that would be my measurement. And then you can only do that for so long, so I have to teach myself how to read the tape measure. So that is definitely a problem I had going into the trade that I am slowly fixing.
No, that's great. I love that. Again, I love how all of you being very honest about some challenges, including ones that are skill sets that are required and how you're resolving to improve them every month, every year. I'll stay with you, Brandy. What are some, call them misunderstandings that people get wrong about skilled trades in general that you might set the record straight about?
I don't know about general, but I guess I could relate it to women. Again, going back to an earlier conversation, guys, males, don't think we are capable physically or mentally able to do the job. Like, I've been at some pretty nasty job sites or in some really tough situations that you have all the guys are like, you sure you can handle that? Like, can you do that? Like, yes, I can. So judging us, I guess, would be a myth, because you'd be surprised how well a female can do the job compared to a male.
Great.
That's
great.
A myth, I would say.
Terrific. And Amanda, I'm sure you agree, but any other myths?
So myths against the trades, I would say one of the biggest myths I've heard is we're not smart. Some of the smartest people I know are in the trades, and that it's not challenging. Being in the trade is very challenging, both physically and mentally. It takes a lot out of you.
Absolutely. I completely agree with you, myself included, and many others I know, if you ask around, right? Anyone who sort of meets a tradesperson unfamiliar, starts talking to them, realizes that they have a specialization and the smarts that go far beyond people's expectations. So again, back to this theme of, it's really oftentimes surprising people based on their assumptions. How about you, Victoria? Any myths that you'd like to address?
For me, it's the stereotypical, oh, they're just a plumber, they're dumb, right? Mm-hmm. The dumb plumber joke, always, I always get it. There's so much more to plumbing than what meets the eye, really. And likewise for the rest of the trades, just like Amanda was saying, there's brains in the head, and it is mentally and physically exhausting.
Yeah, I agree. It is really strange. You see an electrical panel, you see a set of pipes under the sink, and you don't know what to do. And you have to call someone who's smart in that particular area and has transferable skills to do other types of skilled trades if they wanted to. So let's talk a little bit about the Ontario Youth Apprenticeship Program, OYAP. You all have experience there. What's that been like for you, Victoria? And why would you recommend it to young women who are interested in starting a skilled trade?
For anyone interested in learning more about any skilled trade at all, this program opens up a wide variety of opportunities. For me, it was the plumbing trade. I was able to be mentored into it and allowed to go into my first term of schooling because of this program while I was still in high school. It is great to see different trades as well. Like, I got to experience welding, some carpentry, and a little bit of electrical too.
That's great, Victoria. And Brandy, how about you? Why would you recommend the OYAP program?
I would definitely recommend the OYAP program. It benefited me, and it'll probably benefit anyone that's interested in the trade. I started OYAP during my co-op, and I actually was doing school. My schooling was in the evening, so it was twice a week, 6 till 10, welding theory after I had done a full day of co-op. It was really hectic, but I don't regret it. It helped me because by the time I graduated, I had all my first year done, and I was done high school, and all my co-op hours went towards my apprenticeship hours, so that helped a lot.
Wow.
So if anyone is doing co-op, yeah, I'd recommend it.
Incredible. I had not heard of that. I'm sure it's probably common to do those evening courses, but I'm not sure many people were aware. And that's a great way to accelerate. How about you, Amanda? OYAP program are certainly a beneficiary of it. How so, and why would you recommend it?
So first of all, I would recommend it because it costs you nothing. It's a great way to jumpstart into a number of careers. It's a good way to dip your toes in and get some experience. And if you decide it's not the thing for you, there's no harm.
That's right. If you don't like something, you can try something else too, right? In that co-op program through OYAP. So final words, I'll start with you, Amanda. What's your advice for any girls who are interested in the skill trades now, but maybe are afraid or of what other people might say? You know, people make assumptions and they're a little bit concerned of what others might say about their choice. What do you say to them?
Yeah, so honestly, there's no need to. I know that's easier said than done. But I've been fortunate. I had a great support system through high school and out with family and friends, helping me push to what I wanted to do. I feel like if it's something you want to do and it makes you happy, you shouldn't let anyone dictate or take that away from you. We as women or people, we need to push past this barrier, this barricade that's been created, because I feel like the more women we get in the trades, the better. And I think we're ready for it.
Very well said. And Brandy, how about you? What would you say to young women who are thinking of the trades but need that little advice to go keep going?
I would say if you have at all thoughts or thinking you might be interested or you want to give it a try, do it. You won't regret it. And if you don't like it, you can always change it and do something else. But if you have that thought in your head, do it. Don't second guess it. Do it. You won't regret it.
I love it. Those two words, do it. How about you, Victoria? Last word to you. What's your advice for the girls watching today?
As Amanda and Brandy said, honestly, if you have that idea, go for it. High school is a perfect time to experiment and see what you like. You may not like one trade, but another trade might be right up your alley. And there's no cost.
And on that note, Victoria, Brandy, Amanda, this is a wonderful discussion. I think there are many people watching who found you all very relatable and inspirational. It's obvious that your futures are very bright, and we're looking forward to following your careers. Thank you all very much.
Thank you.
Thank you.
And thank you, everyone, for watching. Up next is our discussion with employers. Stay tuned.